I'm working with a US surgeon who was in Afghanistan, and we lost three Australian lives from an Iraqi rebel, and was on campus there having lunch, and my US surgeon friend went to get them as fast as they can and just told me they just died immediately. They bled out. So after a few beers, I said, "What? How can I help? What do you need?" And he said, "I need 10 minutes. And he could have got them back.
Traumatic injury is one of the leading causes of death worldwide every year. On the battlefield in particular, we have a very high combat casualty rate still with all of the technology, with all of the medical devices that we have available to us. You've got combat medics that are there on the field and they have very limited resources to save those patients.
I came to Townsville in 2008, posted to the 1st Battalion here, deployed to Afghanistan in June 2009. I do remember the initial bleeding. My mate's putting two tourniquets on me, still couldn't stop the bleed.
ALM is three drugs, adenosine, lidocaine, magnesium. It places the body in a mild hibernating state whereby the blood pressure does not drop to the low life-threatening values, but it maintains in what they call a hypertensive state. So not only does it resuscitate and improve cardiac function, the combination has a potent effect to reduce internal blood loss by up to 60%.
So we're trying to develop something that's given on the field at the site of injury to stabilise a patient and stop their bleeding, so they have a much better chance of getting to hospital alive. They estimated in Iraq and Afghanistan there was 2,000 soldiers that could have been saved.
I know wives and children that maybe could have had Dad come back home if this was around. When you're on the front line and you're a long way from any sort of hospital, or this has the ability to save lives and reduce the ongoing effects of that initial trauma. It's pretty amazing research.
This is an environment that 87% of most soldiers in these far forward environments die even before they reach a medical treatment facilities. We're working in those first 10, 15 minutes to resuscitate the soldiers and save their lives.
It's got so many various applications. We're up in North Queensland where there's farm injuries that occur in isolated places all the time. The fact that these people could buy time, and time's just precious in these situations.
As well as brain injuries, concussions, we've got one punch victims, we've got brain hemorrhages happening every 18 minutes. 10% of all deaths worldwide every year are due to traumatic injury. It doesn't get the same coverage as cancer, as diabetes, as all of those other things, but yet it disproportionately kills young people. There's so many preventable deaths and we need to do something about that.